Just quick Wigster, might just take those two bolts out there, undo those, that'll lift out, and your snorkel is just into the front of the airbox there. So anyway, I'll pull this off and show you. There you go, mate, that's literally less than a minute. And just lift him out of there. And you've got a rubber boot in here. Not sure if you can see that, but it's just a press fit. So you just work him out like that. Give him a pull. That's it. Well done, she's out. So yeah, just give it a clean, push it back into the hole, which you can see under there. Whack it back together. 10 minutes, all good. This is the last Navaride tyre. She was getting a bit loose towards the end of the ride and might need replacing soon. Bit of fun on the Oxy there, you can see right in the corners on the outside knob. Just a little bit of a chicken strip, but not too bad for an old bike. The only other damage from the Navaride was a broken indicator. The other one went to broke on the Lithgow ride first thing in the morning. There was a few witnesses to that one. This one in the deep sand section, because well, that's how TB gets his jollies, by sending big adventure bikes through soft sand. Sick bastard that he is. But anyway, replace those lenses. But yeah, twice on its side, and that's the only damage it's copped. So far so good. Righto, Wigster, if I'm going to do a video, I'm going to do a video. There's a couple of chemicals here you might need. Have something to drink so you don't wig out if you get it wrong. I try not to use petrol or caro on foam filters if I can help it. This is our CT14 degreaser. It's basically from the trucking industry. CT18 is a really good product. It's a wash as well. Just mix it up 20 to 1 in a spray bottle, layer it on, give it a bath in some bucket of water, and eventually, you might have to do it a couple of times, but you'll come up clean as you need it to. To re-oil, theoretically, if you're going to do a foam filter properly, you should really use an oil bath, just in a plastic bag, drench the crap out of it, squeeze out the excess, and bolt it back on. Because it's only a pre-filter, I'm going to use just the spray-on stuff. A bit dangerous for doing the main filter on your Kato dirt bike or something, but the trick with it is just to be really, really generous. You might only get a few oils out of that. Because it's a spray, you get a bit of waste, but it's nice and easy and it's not as messy. So anyway, yeah, don't use motor oil on your foam filter, mate, but you've got to oil up before you put it back in. While you're waiting for your coxop to dry, the other thing you can do is just feed your hand up. You'll feel the bottom of your filter. This is the dirty side from underneath. Just rub your fingers across the fins. Clean as a whistle, mate. That pre-filter is working a treat. That was caked on with mud and dirt after the last Navaride, so yeah, as far as I'm concerned, that's the best bloody, I don't know what it costs, 70 bucks or whatever it is I've spent.
Morning.
Righto, Wigster, every big red cock sock needs lots of lube, so just I can get into her. Probably should have gone and got me little rubber gloves, but anyway, just work her in. You can see how much is on there. Heaps. Probably more on there than will come with it standard, but anyway, it's a good thing. If you put too much on, you just got to change it more often. You put too little on and you'll be changing your main filter. It's got to be the most bizarre looking accessory I've ever bought for a motorcycle, that. Righto.
Yep, so it took like 2 seconds to just slip it back into the back of the airbox. I just sat the bottom in first in the groove and then just worked the top in, and considering it's all covered in oil, it just pops straight in. So mate, get into it, good luck, and yeah, let us know how it goes. Cheers. Just one more thing, mate, that's there's a rubber flap on the back of this, right across it. It's the only thing that keeps dust out of this compartment here. So just try and get a good seal, like down the down there, so you can't see too much light. And don't forget to hook your battery strap back up, because that goes on this plastic bit here. All these three sections here meet up with the receivers on there. So that's basically just a press fit with one bolt holding it in, so you'll be fine. You would have figured that out by now anyway.